Hey everybody, welcome to Gearhead Daily, and today we're going to be running down the top 10 car movies of all time. Let's get started. Number 10, Fast and Furious. I'm going to put this one up here as the whole entire franchise and not just the first movie, because the first one was hilarious for many reasons. No actual car knowledge was actually being handed down, and the realism was pretty bad. I mean, we all can look at the danger to manifold, boop, 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 you know, blinking lights. However, it did help spawn a new generation of car enthusiasts. Now, if we could stop, you know, getting them to, you know, paint their cars neon orange and pink, that might be helpful. And of course, the memorable line is, "Nobody comes here for the tuna." Number 9, the movie Rush. Now, this movie is based on a true story of sort of what could have happened in real life. Now, the racing part is legit because we have video footage of that, but it is a pretty neat fictionalized version of what F1 is like. Niki Lauda was a part of making it, so it still paints a pretty good story and has some pretty cool car stuff. Number 8, Mad Max. It's funny, it's grotesque, and it's got Nitro. In a post-apocalyptic world, we kind of hope all cars sort of look like this in the future. However, you know, the rest of post-apocalyptic world seems pretty unbearable. It's still fun. There's not a whole lot of real car stuff going on, but, you know, it's fun. Number 7, Vanishing Point. This is the old classic from the 70s where there's a supercharged Dodge Challenger, although we never do see the engine, which is kind of a load of crock, but it does race through the desert, have some package delivered. There's no plot whatsoever. However, it's just all just gratuitous Dodge Challenger driving around the desert, which, you know, the ending, you know, if you've seen it, sorry for the spoilers, but there is a bit of a cop-out at the end, and they could have done better, but it makes up for it with the card nerdgasms. Number 6, Le Mans, featuring Steve McQueen. Now, if Steve McQueen wasn't badass enough, just kind of being Steve McQueen and being all car guy himself, a good portion of the movie was filmed during the actual 24 Hours of Le Mans, which was pretty cool. Now, it was a box office flop, but, you know, good luck finding anything outside of Truth in 24, which is pretty much a self-aggrandizing, you know, flick anyway. It's all racing, very little dialogue, hits all the high notes of a great racing movie, and if you like the old school racers, this is the one to watch. Number 5, Drive. Okay, so it's not really a car movie in the same respect that, you know, it's car chases and things like that. There is one car chase that's in it, and it's not truly in the spirit of a, you know, true car movie. However, it's a darn good movie. The colors are excellent. The sound is excellent. Some people found it a little slow and the pacing to be a bit off, but I found this to be just a fantastic movie with cars as kind of the backdrop. Number 4, American Graffiti. It's a classic. What more do you need to know? Number 3, Love the Beast, with Eric Bana. And if you've ever had a relationship with a car, this movie will get you right in the heart. If you haven't had the pleasure, you'll soon find out. The movie has great cameos by Jay Leno, Jeremy Clarkson, and of course Eric Bana. And it follows the time Eric Bana crashed his very first car in the very first race when he rebuilt it into a tree. Really, the story is about him and his buddies rebuilding this car, but it's more about a love relationship with cars. Number 2 is Senna. This movie is great for people who don't even like cars. The documentary is put together in such a way that makes it very enjoyable for everybody. But you will also see how, you know, corrupt the FIA is. And you'll see, unfortunately, how Senna passes away from a wreck that he has at Imola. But this really is a really great tribute to his work and his driving. And finally, number 1, the original Gone in 60 Seconds. Extremely light on plot and heavy on Vaseline covered on the lens. The original Gone in 60 Seconds is a non-stop car chase that's 45 minutes filmed in real California highways with real California traffic. There's a rumor that the director, H.B. Halicki, knew that the California Highway Patrol didn't like to work weekends, so he'd film the more dangerous car chase highway scenes at those times. If you do listen to the commentary, that's one of the things that they say. Also, one of the cool things about this movie is it was only shot with one Mustang being the crash vehicle. There were a few other ones that were made for the beauty shots, but how many recent movies can you recall that have had one car that they smashed through the entire thing? Extremely light on plot. Don't expect much from it. But if you want nonstop you know, cars smashing into each other and just pure mayhem, this is the movie for you. Thanks everybody for watching our top 10 list. If you like us, please subscribe at the bottom.